So at full camber, I can still actually penetrate quite well. I can afford to use a little more up elevator to hold it and to slow it down even more. But I kind of like this speed. It provides me some maneuverability. There's a little buoyancy right there. And we're going to just see what that does to us lift-wise. We'll take a wrap here. Notice the how long that turn was and how we're going to make no penetration here. And the next time around, we're going to drift even further downwind. That's the effect of flying a constant bank angle, constant speed turn, and actually staying with the wind as you drift downwind with a thermal. That's the effect of that. Mark Drela has some very nice graphics that describe this spirograph type of effect as your circle gets translated downwind. And actually, that's a fairly decent piece of lift. It's not climbing very fast, but it is climbing. And since there is quite a bit of wind, the one thing you want to keep in mind is coming back home from downwind is very, very important that you start home early, because your glide angle into the wind is going to be significantly steeper than if there were no wind at all. And again, significantly steeper than that would be coming home from an upwind position. So you can see how fast we've drifted. You can see that we haven't climbed near as fast as we really should have for a long flight. This is, if we had to stay up 10 minutes in this, we'd have to abandon that thermal, get rid of the camber, speed the airplane up slightly so we can penetrate, and come back, look for the next thermal.